Thank you. Welcome back. We are still discussing the referendum bill. Already two bills are before the National Assembly that are sponsored by the JLAC and another one sponsored by the CIOC. And we were just trying to look at the CIOC, this particular bill, talking to the chairperson of the CIOC with regard to this particular bill. And we were at a place where we were talking about the Punguza Mzigo referendum and how you dealt with it. Carry on.
I must say that we did not quite help Dr. Aukot. Because we were not ready with the referendum bill. And that is why our committee quickly said that to help the country, can we come up with a bill as quickly as we can? And we did. And let me tell you that we consulted far and wide. The legal minds in this town had an input in that bill. Ordinary Kenyans had an input in that bill. But as I said, we'll again try and make sure that what we got from all those sources informs the bill that is on the floor. But let me say that it is important that the laws or the mandate of both CIOC and JLAC is sorted out, looked into by the House Business Committee, because CIOC mandate comes from the Constitution. The one for JLAC is from the studying orders. And a first-year student at the School of Law will tell you that our constitution is supreme. And I think we need to, even as the institution with the mandate to protect the constitution as provided for at Article 94 and 95, we need to wake up to that reality and provide for room and space for CIOC. Let me say this. If CIOC is allowed to play its role properly, and it's supported adequately by Parliament, we will not be having the BBI process today. It would have been done by the CIOC during the 11th Parliament. But the 11th Parliament almost killed CIOC. We've woken it up, and I can tell you the BBI 2, BBI 3 should be handled by the CIOCs of the future.
Yes, looking at it, just talking about the BBI process and the how CIOC was maybe elbowed from the process, we saw there was that time when we came to auditing our constitution. The Budget and Appropriations Committee was given that task to audit the constitution. Yet some executive members feel CIOC would have been better placed because it's the one charged with the mandate of oversighting implementation. Your take?
The issues of constitution, impediment and gaps are issues that are going to be there in the life of this document. And the sooner we wake up to the reality that ensuring that the constitution is implemented for the benefit of Kenyans is a day-to-day activity. It is not a one-off. Unfortunately, those who were there during the 11th Parliament thought that we passed the constitution and we are done. They did not understand that there are articles in the constitution that will need to be looked at. Some of them will need to be listed. Others will need to be reworked so that they become more effective for the future. So what we are now seeing is that realization coming into play. This document is a live document, and the CIOC must live with it.
Yes, looking at it just lastly, the last point, we also have an issue with the IEBC. Since 2018, when we saw the commissioners, April, the three commissioners leave the commission, to date, IEC still has three commissioners. And we had an effort to have a bill to have the commissioners elected in office. Only 18 months of the election, IEBC still not properly constituted.
Having been informed by our problems with the elections, as a committee, again, the first thing we did was to call IBC in place. We came up with a bill that was going to give them the legality that is now being charged all over. But again, Parliament, through the House Business Committee, sat on the bill. Another bill was developed by JLAC. It was brought and fast-tracked. Ours is still pending somewhere in the corridors of power in Parliament, something that Parliament should never be, proud of. That is a dark plot.
Thank you so much. That is Jeremiah Kioni, the chairperson of the Constitution of Implementation Oversight Committee, just sharing to us some of the issues that pertain to the floor of the House when it comes to legislation. And now he's already said that there's need for the two committees to come together for the House Business Committee to ensure that they carry out their mandates in a proper manner so that we don't have this issue of conflicting when it comes to legislating. From here at KCC, I'm Patrick Amimo. Back to you, Ashley.
Thank you very much, Patrick Amimo, for that. Of course, we will continue giving you updates on this developing story.